Good day, everyone. For this particular video, we will be discussing about the interrelationships among components of the natural world, particularly focusing on biological or the biotic factors. So an environment is comprised of two basic components, the abiotic components and the biotic components. So as we all know, abiotic components are the non-living components in our ecosystem, while biotic components are those living organisms in our ecosystem. So the components of the ecosystem is presented here in this particular diagram, wherein the ecosystem could be divided into biotic components and abiotic components. Because as we all know, an ecosystem is an area wherein biotic components and abiotic components are actually interacting with one another. So when we talk about biotic components, we have producers, consumers, and decomposers. And this consumer is actually also divided into categories such as your primary consumer, known as herbivores, secondary consumers, and tertiary consumers, which are all either carnivores or omnivores. For the abiotic components, we have examples such as air, water, wind, soil, temperature, and rainfall. All of these are the non-living things that we can see around us. Now, for biotic, it includes all living things present in the ecosystem, such as your bacteria, protists, algae, fungi, plants, and animals. As you can see in this picture, we have different types of living things or biotic factors. To name a few, we have plants, bacteria under the microscope, of course, humans, fungus, mushroom, archaea, protists, and animals. So autotrophs require only inorganic nutrients and an outside energy source to produce organic nutrients for their own use and indirectly for all the other members of the ecosystem. So autotrophs are also known to be called or are also called as producers because they produce their own food and they are capable of producing energy. So autotrophs are basically plants in our ecosystem such as this and also some organisms which are capable of producing their own food such as your algae, phytoplanktons under the ocean, and also, some bacteria, such as your cyanobacteria, which can utilize, which could also produce their own food as a source of energy. So, algae contain chlorophyll and carry on photosynthesis in freshwater and marine habitats. Photosynthesizing organisms suspended in water. These are your algae suspended in water, above the water, or in the surface of water. And trees, as we all know, are photosynthesizers on land. Next would be consumers. When we talk about consumers, generally, they are called as heterotrophs. They need a preformed source of organic nutrients. They are not capable of producing their own food, like the autotrophs or the plants, since they lack chlorophyll. So the tendency is for them to feed on these autotrophs and transfer energy from one organism to another through the food chain. So we have the types of heterotrophs. We have herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, which could actually eat both plants and also consume meat, detritivores, eat detritus, parasites, saprophytes, and filter feeders. Now, just to review, when we talk about herbivores, these are actually animals that graze directly on plants or algae. Their main source of food are vegetation. They are eating plants or grasses. So that's their source of nutrition. So the different herbivores are cow, horse, elephant, parrot, caterpillars, termite, koala, zebra, and a lot more. When I talk about carnivores, they feed on other animals. So to name a few, we have, of course, grizzly bear, black bear, cheetah, mountain lion, lion, timber wolf, and a lot more. And we'll talk about omnivores. They feed on both plants and animals, such as dogs, pigs, bear, hedgehog, raccoon, ostrich, groundhog, opossum, and also including us humans. Now, we have here a category known as scavengers, wherein they actually feed on dead remains of animals and also on plants that have recently begun to decompose. So, for example, we have hyena, fox, jackal, marabou stork, opossum, vulture, seagull, hornet, raccoon. Okay, so wherein their particular food source are actually in the state of decomposition. Now, we talk about detritus. It is a term used to refer to organic remains in the water and soil that are in the final stage of decomposition. So these are actually good source of nutrients for the soil and also for the plants. So decomposers are bacteria and fungi, including mushrooms. Use their digestive secretion to chemically break down dead organic matter, including animal waste, in the external environment. So to name a few of the decomposers, we have worm, mushroom, insects, and bacteria. So their interaction within the ecosystem between biotic components is actually could be seen through a food chain, wherein a food chain, from the word chain, is actually a single structure, because if you have interconnected or interlinked food chain, we now call it as food web. So when I talk about food chain, it's only a single line. It talks about the sequence wherein one organism is being eaten by another organism. So basically, this is a relationship between your biotic components in the ecosystem. So food chain refers to order of events in an ecosystem where one living organism eats another organism, and later that organism is consumed by another larger organism. So the flow of nutrients and energy from one organism to another at different trophic levels form a food chain. So to start with, we will try to interpret this diagram. We have here the producer, basically the grass, being eaten by the grasshopper as the primary consumer. So the direct food source is the grass. This primary consumer, which is the grasshopper, is being eaten by the mice, which is now classified as a secondary consumer. The mice will be eaten by the snake, which will become the tertiary consumer. And the final consumer in this particular food chain is the hawk, wherein it will eat the snake. And when this hawk actually die after some time, it will be decomposed by fungi. So we call fungi as an example of the compost. That's it for the biotic components in the ecosystem. We'll see you in the next video.